When it comes to the wiring on our cars, the relay is one of the elements we rely on in order to be able to switch high current outputs from a low current drive from the likes of an ECU. I'm here with Reid from Kaizenspeed, who's got an interesting take on the relay, and it's not often we see something that's a relatively new innovation with what is a very well-developed technology. So, Reid, what was wrong with the conventional mechanical relay for a start?
Okay, so it's since 1985, nothing's changed in the relay world. Like, they're electric and mechanical, they can't be pulsed. Exposed contacts is pretty common, and even the ones that are weatherproof require crimped connectors, pins, and a lot of forethought. So I've been installing relays for a really long time. Every time I install one, I think there has to be a better way to share power and ground and create power distribution that isn't a PDM that's so expensive and require a lot of forethought.
Let's just go back there a little bit, because you've used a couple of terms I want to dive into. So PDM, power distribution module, and that's something we're seeing a lot in professional motorsport. Solid state relays essentially that are controlled via a complete unit, but also quite expensive. And then you've also talked about the mechanical relays there with the exposed contacts. So you've gone away from that technology as well. You've gone to a standalone solid state relay. So something sort of between a conventional relay and a power distribution module.
That's exactly right. So we've kind of fixed everything about a regular relay. And then we have a product that does a lot of the things that a PDM can do, but it's one at a time. So the barrier to purchase is a lot lower, right? There's no big barrier to purchase. If you can afford and install a relay, you can afford and install a Kaizen relay.
So where's the advantages with the Kaizen relay over and above the fact it's a solid state relay?
Okay, so most importantly, they interconnect. So if you can apply power to one relay, the second, third, and fourth relay gets its power and ground simply by interconnecting. No additional wire splicing whatsoever.
So this is really the idea of basically simplifying your wiring installation, because this can be quite a time-consuming process when you are wiring up a number of relays. You've got to run power, loop that across to each of the relays. So you do this internally?
That's right. We do it internally with pogo pins, and the pogo pins can handle 40 amps per unit and 100 amps per bank of relays. So really what we're trying to do is just reduce wiring and make it easy, because let's be honest, usually what happens is someone will need one or two, maybe three relays, as opposed to, you know, an entire PDM. But what happens with every project is they grow. So one, two, and three turns into four, five, and six. And so what we're trying to do is make that easier on the installer and really just clean up the wiring and make it easier to install.
So when you're daisy chaining these relays together, adding an additional relay onto it, what's the physical process of attaching that second relay? How do you go about doing it?
Sure, so they just connect together and rotate and lock. And as soon as they're locked together, you know, they're permanently that way. So you would literally just insert, rotate, they're locked together. Now, the other thing that we do is every one of our devices can be installed without tools. And so that's really important to me, because while a lot of motorsports guys are very passionate about their crimped pins, we're using spring cage technology, which is widely accepted internationally, in fact, for industrial automation. Ridiculous amount of shock and vibration resistance. So I think we're going to start seeing a lot more of that spring cage technology being used in motorsports.
Let's just talk about that a little bit, because this is quite interesting. I do come from that background. With motorsport wiring, we are very pedantic about using the right connectors and crimp tooling, time consuming, etc. So that technology, well tested, you're absolutely confident, vibration, the motorsport sort of scenario is not going to cause an issue to it?
I think it's better, in fact, and I think that that can be very reasonably argued. So I just think that right now, because it isn't something that we're used to, the old guard is going to say, I like this my way, and God bless you.
So you're going to have to really change a few minds in order to get this across the line, fair to say?
Well, that's right, and it wouldn't be fun if we weren't doing that.
All right, so talk to us about how that actual connection process goes. You've got your wire. Obviously, conventionally, we would wire strip some insulation off that. We'd crimp on a terminal and then connect that to our relay. So talk us through the process you use for the Kaizen relay.
Sure, so a wire would come in. It's got insulation to the end. You'd strip off a section of insulation, lift up a lever, and on our device, that compresses a spring cage clamp, you'd insert the wire through an elastomer seal and then snap the lever down, and now that is permanently there until the lever is lifted again.
So it really does make it easy to both connect and disconnect, and no special tooling required.
Yeah, no special tooling. Most importantly, think about this. If you need to pull your wire harness through a firewall, you're going to have to de-pin your connector, and with ours, you're not going to have to do that. So there are a lot of advantages that I think are going to become clear over time as people use this and kind of their eyes widen as you know, it becomes useful and little things make it easier to work around the vehicle.
Now, when you're inserting that wire, you said there's an elastomer seal, so is this relatively protected from moisture ingress?
Absolutely. So it's the same type of seal that you'd see on like a Deutsch connector or something like that. Yep.
All right, so now actually actuating the relay. So again, conventionally with a mechanical or a solid state relay, we're actuating it with an electrical signal from the ECU. Yeah. I believe you can still do that with a Kaizen relay, but you've got another interesting option for actuating these relays. Can you talk to us about that?
Sure, so we have a control module that also can click right on the side. In the same way that you can interconnect the control module. That control module is very small, very, very small. Single CAN bus, three analog inputs and three analog outputs.
Okay, so you can then control the output of up to those three relays using a CAN signal from the likes of an ECU or a dash logger?
Absolutely. Any aftermarket ECU, OEM CAN bus. And most importantly, the hardware is inexpensive enough that it makes sense for manufacturers to include it with their kits and write their own firmware that is vehicle specific or application specific for those products.
But of course, for those who aren't running a CAN bus in their car or don't have the ability to write a custom template for the CAN bus, you can still actuate these relays conventionally.
Of course, you can switch high or switch low, and it can be pulsed up to 20,000 hertz. So.
Now, the other nice feature I've seen on these relays is you've actually got some LED sort of status indicators on that. And conventionally, when we're testing a system, sometimes it can be a little bit tricky to know if you've got a relay that's not working, you've got a wiring issue or a control issue. So you can tell us how those indicators work and how you can test the relay?
Yeah, absolutely. So we just did what should be done on any even conventional relay, which is an override button. So as soon as you're done with your wiring, you can just depress a non-latching momentary button to verify that everything's working. We've got two LEDs that will indicate to you that everything's working. One LED lights up with trigger, one LED lights up with output, and the right LED actually also will turn red if the device is starting to be overloaded.
So you've got a bit of sort of diagnostics built into that as well?
Right, a little bit of feedback, at a glance feedback.
Now, you also did touch on this earlier on, but I just want to bring this back. So again, one of the advantages with the solid state relay, whether it's yours or any solid state relay, is it can be pulse width modulated. So fair to say, this then allows you to do speed control of the likes of fuel pumps or thermofans?
Absolutely, light bars, anything. We can strobe, we can dim and brighten lights, control motor speed, fans, pumps. Yeah.
Now you
have soft start as well.
Now, you've won the SEMA Launchpad Award this year at SEMA 2019, so I think that's a $10,000 check that you get to take away. Obviously, this is still in development. Can you tell us what the likely time frame of when people will be able to buy these, and what are they going to be expecting to pay for them?
Sure. So this is going to be end of 2020, so a year from now they'll be available. They'll be $100 a piece, so $100 a relay and $100 a control module. So if you compare... Well, first of all, there's nothing that you can compare this to, but the control module, very inexpensive. The reason we do that, we want manufacturers, shops, OEMs, suppliers to take this hardware, create their own firmware for it, and sell it as their device.
Now, I think it's probably worth mentioning here about the cheapest PDM that I've come across so far is still north of $1,000 US. So it is a very cost-effective solution, particularly for those people, as you mentioned, who are only looking at adding a few relays. Look, great technology there, Reid. Really applaud you on the innovation and wish you all the best. If people want to reach out and find out more, how can they get hold of you?
Sure. So please check out our website, kaizenspeed.com. It's KAIZENSPEED.com.
Thanks, Reid. Good luck for the rest of the show.
Appreciate you, sir.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.